London just can't cope with the number of remand prisoners awaiting trial. In the next few days, about a dozen will be taken from police cells in London to the newly rebuilt cells at Launceston in Cornwall, 250 miles away. An export the force in Cornwall don't want, but so far there's nothing they can do about it. The Home Office has paid for the cells to be brought up to prison standard. The 12 Londoners will be housed two to each of the six cells. Extra security equipment's been installed, and prison regulations insist the men have a room to meet in and have library facilities. It costs £200 a night to keep prisoners in police cells, but the police themselves are not happy at learning to be jailers.
They are working in conditions which they are not used to, as in fact prison wardens. They are working on their rotary leave days, and although they are being recompensed by way of overtime, they are working longer hours, 12-hour shifts, and this in itself is not conducive to good working conditions. They are missing their rotary leave days, and this is placing greater stress upon both the manpower itself and upon the families of those men.
It's come to a head since the prison officers in the capital's three main jails began their industrial action in protest at undermanning and overcrowding. More than 1,000 prisoners are now being held in police stations in London and the Home Counties. Another 363 are locked up in stations as far afield as Avon, Yorkshire and Plymouth. Since July, 24 London prisoners have been kept at Crown Hill Police Station in Plymouth. And there, as in other regional forces, overtime and manning levels have been cut, putting an extra strain on the force. No one knows how long it'll go on. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.